In a courtroom, you hear "all rise" when the judge comes in. What about the bow of your boat? Stick around to find out all about trim on today's video. Hi, I'm Sean from Lens Cove Lessons in Boating. We get questions all the time about how to properly use your trim. And we also witness customers are on the lake who don't properly know how to trim their engine. And really, the power trim on your boat engine, whether it's an outboard powered boat or a stern drive IO powered boat, is very similar. Although the weight distribution in the boat is a little bit different and how the trim works is a little bit different, the actual physical properties of why you trim the boat in and out are basically the same. So in today's video, we're gonna talk about how a boat is designed and why trim is set up the way it is, the proper way to trim the boat for when you take off and get on plane, how a boat goes down the water and how the boat hull and the boat water surface go together to make the boat riding experience, and how to use trim a little bit better to get the most fuel efficient, calm, quiet ride. Boat transoms are designed, typically speaking, at a negative angle to vertical. And what we mean by that is that the back of the boat where the engine is mounted is not straight up and down. There are some boats that are manufactured with a 0 degree transom angle, but the vast majority of them are done like this and can be as high as 30 degrees. In North America, the average boat transom angle is actually 14 degrees. Why that is that the vast majority of boats are what we call planing hulls. And a planing hull is a boat that reacts and is most efficient better on the water when it is up on top of the water and when it has broken surface tension on the water, and that is what we call planing. So in order to do that, we have to get all the weight of the boat up on top of the water versus being in it. And that's a lot of work for an engine. So an engine has to do all the effort to get that boat up on plane, and that's where it's most efficient and most comfortable to ride. You get more speed and more fuel efficiency. A boat manufacturer does that so that when the engine is trimmed all the way down, it's actually trimmed in. So here is about approximately straight up and down or vertical or 0 degrees. And as you see, as you trim it down, it actually, what we call, tucks in to give an angle of attack from the propeller that actually pushes the boat up on plane. So whether you have a outboard powered bow rider or a stern drive powered bow rider, or you have a cruiser or you have a pontoon boat, you're gonna find that the vast majority of them have a negative transom angle. So, using the boat. You decide to go out on the water for the day. Most of the time, you're gonna want to eventually get up on plane. Whether you wanna get up on plane or you just wanna cruise at slow speeds, our recommendation is that you trim the engine all the way down so that it has a negative trim angle. And what that'll do when you go to get up on plane and you accelerate, it will help lift that boat up out of the water with as little bow rise as possible. It's also gonna be less energy used by the engine, which is easier on it, and use less fuel. And will increase, or I should say, and it will decrease the time to plane. Once you get on plane and you're going down the lake, you'll notice that if you keep that negative trim angle or all the way down, that the bow is actually being pushed down by the engine. So the attack angle of the blade is actually pushing down, and what it's trying to do is level out. And when it levels out, the prop push, it's going to push the bow of the boat down. So you'll find when you're on plane with the trim all the way down, it tends to steer very heavily. So you'll feel like there's more effort required to steer side to side, and you'll find that the ride doesn't feel smooth because the bow is being pushed down in the water. So our recommendation is that once you get up on plane, you trim up slightly by using the trim switch on your remote control to a point where the engine is, for the most part, straight up and down, which is trim up on your gauge just a little bit. The characteristics of how the boat handles will change. You'll find that the steering loosens up. You'll find that your speed increases without any extra throttle. And everything just feels a little bit smoother on the boat because the bow starts to rise out of the water, and that reduces the wetted surface, and that increases the efficiency as the boat gathers speed. You can continue to trim to a point if you want to get the most possible speed out of it. And usually most outboards and stern drives have what are called a trim limiter in them, and it will stop you when it gets before it gets too high. However, as you trim up, you might find that you get to a point where you hear a loud noise coming from the back of the boat. And what that is what we call aeration and eventually cavitation, where you have trimmed the engine too high and it's actually sucking air from the surface of the water down into the propeller blade, and you will lose bite on the water. It causes a noise, but more importantly, it causes a lack of power, and so your speed and efficiency will decrease. The other thing is that air getting mixed in is actually getting mixed with the exhaust gases coming out of the propeller and can cause cavitation and burn on the propeller as those air molecules pop against the propeller blades as they come together. So make sure you don't trim too high. You'll also notice as you trim, you may get to a point, and every boat hull is different, where the boat starts to bounce, and that's called porpoising. And essentially what you're doing is the trim is too high, so the boat bow is lifting a little bit too much, but it can't sustain that angle of attack, so it bounces back down, and then it comes back up as you push it forward, and it bounces back down. If you feel that boat porpoising or bouncing, trim it down a little bit. So you're going across the lake, everything is fine. Here are some other times you might want to trim up or down. Obviously, when you're getting into shallow water, you're going to be off plane going slowly, and you're going to use as much trim as you need to keep your boat engine safe. When you're going across the lake and it's a bit of a rough day and you're going into some chop, sometimes going into the rough water with the trim down a little bit and getting more of that bow down in to break the wave will help your smooth out the boat ride. Also, when you're taking a tight corner, if you're tubing or doing anything like that, that is going to require the boat to turn sharply, you may want to trim down a little bit, because as you turn sharply, if the trim is up in a higher position, the prop is closer to the surface of the water, and when you turn, the whole boat banks, bringing that prop even closer to the top of the water, and it can break tension with the water and you can lose power. One other quick tip, particularly if you don't have a trim gauge, or even if you do, is that when the trim is going down, you'll hear a change in tone, which is actually the hydraulic bypass, when it goes all the way down and hits the transom. So listen carefully, you'll hear the difference between trimming down and trim down. That sound change in tone is when you're all the way at the bottom. Some boats have trim gauges on them and others don't. Don't rely on them 100% because they're very finicky, and you have to set up a trim switch on the engine to show the position, and they can be miscalibrated fairly frequently. Really, the best trim advice you can give is how it feels. Look at your engine when you go to take off, make sure it's trimmed all the way down. And as you're trimming up, even though your gauge may or may not be moving and you may not have a trim gauge, you will feel a fairly significant change in how that boat performs, and there'll be a sweet spot in just a bit of trim before it gets too high and you get cavitation, and it's too low and you have bow steer. Also, remember, on a pontoon boat, particularly ones of low horsepower, ones that don't have lifting strakes or tritunes, or ones that are very long, like 25 foot plus, will not have the same reaction to trim as a stern drive or an outboard powered bow rider, just because of the way the hull is different than the pontoons are. So trim is really important on your boat. It can really save you money on fuel. It can smooth out your ride and make it more enjoyable. And it can improve the performance both on the top end, speed, and on the bottom end, acceleration and time to plane. So learning how to use it properly can change your boating dramatically. One quick tip is when you get back to the dock, if you remember, put the trim all the way back down so it's ready to go for the next time. Thank you for joining us on Lens Cove Lessons in Boating for today's video. Remember to like this video and subscribe for more.
Be safe, have fun, and we'll see you out on the water.